Boys and girls and my dear teachers, welcome to A.P.M.S. Puttur. I am Sheikh Mahbub Basha, PGT Physics. This video is about concave mirror and ray diagrams. Assume a hollow glass sphere. Its center. Its radius. Cut a small portion from the sphere. If the inner surface is coated, then it becomes convex mirror. If the outer surface is silvery coated, then it becomes a concave mirror. Select a concave mirror. The geometric center of the mirror will be the pole, and a line passing through the pole and perpendicular to the mirror will be principal axis. So, principal axis, pole, center of the sphere or center of curvature, a set of parallel beams which are also parallel to the principal axis. When incident on the mirror, they converge to a point on the axis, principal axis, it is a focus. And the focus is midpoint of pole and center of curvature. Rule 1. A ray that comes parallel to the principal axis, after reflection, it passes through the focus. Rule 2. A ray that passes through the focus will become parallel to the principal axis after getting reflected. Rule 3. A ray that passes through the center of curvature will again pass through the center of curvature after getting reflected. That means it retraces its path. Now let us see the ray diagrams. Case 1. When the object is at infinity, the rays coming from the object will be parallel. The set of parallel rays also parallel to the principal axis converts to a point called focus, and image will be formed at the focus. It will be a real, inverted and point size image. Case 2. When the object is much beyond C, for practical purposes, the distance greater than 10F is treated as infinity and the rays will be parallel. Parallel rays converge to a point called a focus. Image will be formed at the focus and the image will be real, inverted and diminished. Case 3. When the object is beyond C, two rays are selected, one parallel to the principal axis, another passing through the focus. The intersecting point will be the position of image. So the image is formed between F and C. It will be real, inverted and diminished image. Case 4. When the object is at C, two rays are selected, one parallel to the principal axis, another passing through focus. The intersecting point is the position of image. The image will be a real, inverted and same size as that of the object. Case 5. When the object is between F and C, observe the rays. The intersecting point is beyond C. So the image is formed beyond C and the image will be real, inverted and enlarged. Case 6. When the object is at F, so here we select two rays, one parallel to the principal axis, another passing through center of curvature. So the rays after reflection becomes parallel. Parallel rays will be meeting at infinity. So the image is formed at infinity. It will be a real, inverted and enlarged image. Much, much larger in size than the object. Case 7. When the object is between F and P, that is focus and mirror, observe the rays. The two rays appears to be coming from a point behind the mirror where image is said to be formed. And the image will be a virtual, erect and enlarged image. So all the observations are tabulated. So please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. Yours, Sheikh Mahbub Basha. Thank you.